This drill is called Read and React. It involves a lot of players and it's meant to be done at half speed until the player's eyes are reading and they are communicating correctly. Just a little bit about the setup. Over here you can see that we have a green team and a blue team. The players on the green team are trying to break out of the zone in this direction, and the players on the blue team, loosely speaking, are trying to score on this goal, although the focus of the drill is on helping the green team form good habits. So the blue team is not really aggressively trying to knock pucks off of sticks. Rather, they're trying to be in a position to force the green team to make decisions about reading a play and communication. The way it works is this: the attacking center, that's the blue center here, makes a decision. That center either attacks behind the net this way or, of course, this way. All right. When the drill begins, this green D is behind the net with the puck. These small dots back here are just the spare pucks to feed in to the drill. Let's, for the purpose of teaching, assume that this center chooses this direction to attack behind the net. All at the same time, these players, left wing, right wing, center, and of course the D on the green team, they're not waiting for the puck to move. They are all at the same time reading not the puck but the play. What I mean by that is they are reading the movement of this attacker, and once this attacker decides to attack in this direction, they can start to read the play to get into good position. This should be happening basically simultaneously, not slowly one player at a time as the puck moves. This is what they should be doing. This D, it's pretty obvious, is going to move to this side. Okay? But this winger is also going to move to the half boards. Not when the D moves. This winger is actually reading this attacker. Remember, that winger will go to the half boards and as soon as reasonably possible will be yelling to their D for a pass. All right, they should be yelling, "Ring it," or they should just be calling the name of the defenseman. The "ring it" tells this defenseman that a stick-to-stick pass is not a good option. Right when this center moves, the green center, this player, reads that the puck's going to come around this side of the rink, and therefore this center should be putting themselves in a position to get a pass from this winger. At the same time, this, I'm just going to write the line here for this center. At the same time, this right winger in green is going to read that the puck indeed will be coming around to this side of the ice, so they'll be moving up high in the zone. You can see here we have a good line for passes for a breakout. Okay, the key is to understand that these green players are not reading this one at a time. Rather, all three green forwards, the left wing, center, and right wing, they are reading to go to these areas when they see this attacker choose a side of the net. All right, so let's again spell it out. Once this blue center chooses a side, then all of these players, this left wing is going to read, this center's going to read that he needs to be coming here, this winger's going to read that they need to be getting high in the zone. This winger, remember, needs to be yelling "ring it" or just yelling the name to give that D a choice. This center also needs to yell something to their winger. They need to yell either "boards," in other words, put the puck up the boards, or "middle," put the puck to the middle. How does the center do that? Well, in this drill, these blue defensemen, in this case the right blue, right D blue, I tell them, make a choice. When this puck starts coming up to the wing, either cover the boards or move to the middle to cut off that route. Once this center reads what this D is doing, he needs to yell to the winger which way to go. Now, I guess I would hope it would be a little bit obvious, but if this right D cuts off the boards, this center should be yelling middle, telling this winger that the puck needs to come to this area, and of course, the center would take that route. On the other hand, if this right D chooses to cut off this route, this center needs to be yelling to their winger boards. And in that case, the puck is going to go up the boards, and this center is going to take this route to the boards. Okay? It's about choices, and it's about communicating and reading. Once this puck gets to the neutral zone, in other words, this right winger gets out, this center gets out, and this winger has to skate out, they can all come back in 3-on-2. Who is the 3-on-2 against? The 3-on-2 will be against the 2D. This center drops out of the play, just gets out of the way, as well does this D. Okay? So once they're coming in 3-on-2, this attacking blue center just get to the corner. This D just get to the corner, let the 3-on-2 play to the whistle, and then it will get set up for the next run. Just so you know, in this setup, the right wing, left wing, and centers that I have at the neutral zone here, they're just waiting to get into the play. And of course, when the whistle blows, they'll fill in to their appropriate spots here and go from there. All right. So again, the focus is start at half speed, and you want these green forwards reacting not just to where the puck's going, you want them actually reading where to go early on by reading which way this blue attacking center is headed. And really quickly, I will do the opposite side. Blue attacker comes this way. All at the same time, all four green players read that they need to move. D moves here. This right winger comes to the half boards, yells to their defenseman, ring it, or they just call their name. Center reads that they're going to come up, and they're going to be prepared to yell to their winger boards. In that case, they'll skate to the boards. Middle, in that case, they'll stay towards the middle. That depends on which direction this left D decides to cover. This wing also is reading early on to come to center ice for a pass. Once the puck's out of the blue zone, out of the zone, they come back in 3-on-2, and they're 3-on-2 against these guys, those two blue defense. The attacking center moves to the corner out of the play. The initial D moves out of the play. That is read and react. And in summary, you're looking for the blue attacking center to choose a side. Instead of just green defenseman reading, you are reading that attacking center. You want the defenseman and the green center, the green left wing, and the green right wing all reading and reacting to that blue center. You want your winger yelling for a pass, either ring it or just calling the name. You want your center yelling to your winger, either middle or boards. Once the puck's out, come back in 3-on-2. That is read and react.